40 years William Everett dreamed of making this trip when he retired. In 40 minutes, he'd be off, leaving behind dreary weather forecasts and heading for the sunshine. For his delectation and that of the other passengers, the Canberra will be carrying 78 tons of meat, 250,000 cakes and pastries, freshly baked, of course, and an awful lot of champagne. William took early retirement from his job as a joiner at the Geological Museum, part of the Natural History Museum now, and immediately decided this was the trip for him, even if it does cost £8,000.
I thought I'd be a bit sort of apprehensive, you know, but having met a few people at a luncheon a few weeks back, and they talked about cruises they've been on, it took away a lot of the apprehension I felt, you know, worried about whether I got the right clothing or enough.
Well, he certainly had the right clothes today. After all, you've got to dress the part for a trip like this. And William's no slouch in the sartorial department. But then he knew the kind of reception he and the other passengers were going to get at Victoria. All night, but trains, of course, don't wait for anyone, especially when the train is the Orient Express. Well, the trip of a lifetime is a very special occasion and deserves a very special send-off. Now I ask you, how is this for a boat train? The Orient Express in all her refurbished glory. All that's missing now is a little...
Some champagne, please, sir.
Ah, that's more like it. The only possible way to start a trip like this.
What do you think of it so far?
Marvellous. Absolutely marvellous.
Is it living up to your expectations?
Oh, yes, by all means, yes.
You said you were going to make the most of it, and you said you thought it was going to be fun.
Yes, it will be, without any shadow of doubt.
And how much has the champagne got to do with that?
Nothing at the moment. I haven't drunk enough.
Get on with it, then.
Cheers.
Cheers. Yeah.
The Orient Express was chartered to take 90 of the cruisers to Southampton to get them in the festive mood. Well, it did that all right. Imagine it, 3 months of luxury ahead for everyone booked on this trip, and we were there to share it with them. There was only one stop between Victoria and Southampton, and guess who was getting off while everyone else was getting away?
But our round-the-world trip ended a little sooner than theirs. They're off for 3 months. Meanwhile, we're here. It's true what they say, you know. It is a glamorous life in television. Trisha Ingram's and chums in Clapham for Thames News.